And it was made even more miserable when one of their key players in Johnny Bairstow suffered a fracture to the middle finger of his left hand that must render him a doubt for what are now crucial tests at Southampton in the Oval. What a transformation we have seen here in Nottingham after England were utterly dominant at Lord's, and what a contrast this stupefying day was to the helter-skelter world of modern test cricket. Not that India can be blamed for that. Here was their opportunity, not only to ensure there was no possible escape for England with 2 days left, but also to increase their chances of pulling off one of the great comebacks in test history. At the centre of it, of course, was the imperious figure of Virat Kohli, making sure he would not only reach his 23rd century, but put as many miles as he could into the legs of England's bowlers to leave them fatigued for the battles ahead. How England cursed their inability to dismiss King Kohli in the 90s for a second time in this match, when the hapless Jennings made a total mess of what should have been a comfortable chance with the India captain on 93. Anderson, running in hard over after over to try to compensate for the inadequacies of England's batsmen, could not believe it as the 14th dropped catch already in this series by his fielders, and surely the most symbolic went down. Remember, Anderson had Kohli dropped on 21 by Dawood Malan on his way to 149 in the first test at Edgbaston, and Jennings' drop means that England's record wicket-taker has still not claimed his old rival once in this series. Compare that to the 4 times Anderson dismissed Kohli for just 19 runs here 4 years ago, and you can pinpoint one of the key reasons why India will surely win here today or tomorrow to propel themselves back into this series. From the very next over, Kohli went to 3 figures yet again, and the whole of Trent Bridge, commendably full on a Monday and deserving of more entertainment, rose to give the great batsman the acclaim he deserved. Kohli, with 200 runs in the test, has been at the forefront of the display of application, discipline and good old-fashioned solid batting here that England simply seem unable to muster in the white ball-dominated era. It may not have been pretty, but there is still room for days like this in test cricket, when a match and possibly a series need to be set up, and, to be fair, the crowd at this truly great ground seemed to appreciate what they were watching. England, who seemed to have made significant strides forward in the first 2 tests, were completely deflated, unable to come up with any answers to India's obdurance and butter-fingered again when chances went their way. Joe's Butler started the day by dropping Cheteshwar Pujara at second slip off Anderson on 40, and then took the gloves when Bairstow was struck a painful blow by a late swinging delivery from the same unfortunate bowler. It was immediately clear it was serious as Bairstow covered the damaged digit with his cap and looked distraught as he left the field, and England's worst fears were confirmed when a small fracture was diagnosed by X-ray. And say Bairstow might bat again here, he surely won't, if all is lost, and may play as a batsman in the 4th test at the Aegis Bowl next week, but the gloves will now be back, temporarily at least, with white ball keeper Butler. If Bairstow cannot play, then Moeen Ali is the most likely replacement, with other candidates including James Vince, the most prolific run scorer in county cricket this summer, Rory Burns, Joe Clark, and, with Ed Smith prepared to select outside the box, how about an improbable comeback for Ian Bell? England looked battered, bruised and all but broken by the time Kohli eventually called his side in at 352 for 7, with Ben Stokes hobbling around to put the seal on his ill-judged comeback. And that was surely the India captain's intention when he batted on so long at fewer than 3 and over. At least Cook and Jennings survived the last 9 overs and had reduced England's target to 498, but there was enough movement from the simmers and spin from Ravichandran Ashwin, who appeared to be struggling with a hip injury, to show that England's task remains a near impossible one. And there was the consolation of Adil Rashid quietly going some way to justifying his controversial inclusion in this series with 3 wickets in highly difficult circumstances, but this has been a truly awful match for England. Now they simply have to follow India's example and at least make their opponents work hard for the victory. At least sets up the thrilling series we all expected when these teams brought out such an exciting first test at Edgbaston. If England are to go down, as they surely will, then it has to be fighting. The sight of a loose drive from Virat Kohli, not only evading Keaton Jennings' hands at gully, but also flying through his legs to the utter dismay of Jimmy Anderson, just about summed it all up.